great people welcome constructive criticism. That certainly was the case with regard to Moshe Rabbeinu. In Parashat Yitro, we are told how at the time of the giving of the Torah, Yitro came to visit the Israelite people. Coming into the camp, he saw it firsthand from the methodology that Moshe was applying with regard to the ruling of the people. He didn't like it one bit. And through his comments, Moshe's eyes were opened to appreciate how he could be doing much better. While sometimes we can indeed benefit from the insights of a visitor, often it's important for those who are offering advice to be on the scene, to be part of what is happening. That's why in the book of Bereshit, with regard to the building of the Tower of Babel, we are told Hashem came down to see the city and the tower. Of course, Hashem doesn't have to come down to go anywhere because he is everywhere. But our rabbis explain that Hashem was here teaching us a lesson, that in order to judge a person or a situation, you need to be on the scene. And that's why in the ethics of the fathers we are taught, Al tadun et chavercha ad shetagia limkomo, don't judge others until you come to their place, until you see the context within which they are operating. Don't presume that's what's happening in your area, what you're familiar with, is necessarily the case with regard to others. On the other hand, there can be circumstances in which being part of a situation is a liability when it comes to judging that situation. That's why in halakha we say, Ein eid na'ase dayan. A witness cannot serve as the judge. For example, let's say there's a judge who's in a store. He personally witnesses a thief taking something off the shelf. And then that very thief appears in his court before him. You could argue there could be no better judge than him. But on the other hand, according to halakha, he must step down. Why? Because he's too close to the situation. He was there, and therefore he won't be able to view the entire context in a totally objective way. So emerging out of Parshat Yitro, there are, I believe, two important lessons regarding criticism. First of all, for those who like to give criticism, we need to understand what is really happening on the ground within that scene before we offer our words of advice. And secondly, with regard to those on the receiving end of criticism, to appreciate that sometimes you can be so embroiled in a situation that you lose your capacity to understand what is really going on, and you can appreciate the value of the insights of somebody who's just popping in for a moment. There's a lovely Hebrew saying, Oreach lerega ro'eh kol pega. A visitor who just comes in for a moment sees everything that's going wrong. Let's utilize criticism in the best possible way, as Moshe Rabbeinu did, to become even better people. Shabbat Shalom.